Let's start Chapter 7, Plants. Plants can be found everywhere. Plants are very important to us as they produce most of the food that humans and animals eat. There is presence of plant even in meat. Meat-yielding animals such as chickens and goats feed on plants. Without plants, they would die. Hence, most of the food that we eat comes from plants. Plants also give us shelter, fresh air, fuel and medicine. Structure of a leaf. A leaf is an organ of a plant and is the principal appendage of the stem. Typically, a leaf is a thin flattened organ born above ground and specialized for photosynthesis. A leaf is on external part of a plant's stem. Leaves are the principal structure. In size, leaves range from only several millimeters long to 15 to 18 meters long, as in some palm trees. Leaves are of different colors and sizes. Green leaves derive their color from a green pigment called chlorophyll. The presence of additional pigments causes other leaf colors such as red in coleus and purple in cabbage. Leaf of coleus. Leaf of cabbage. Parts of a leaf. A leaf has three main parts. The base. This is the joining point of the leaf to the stem. The stalk or petiole. The petiole is the connection of the stem to the blade. It can be short or long. It is generally cylindrical or semicircular in shape. The lamina or leaf blade. Blade is the expanded part of the leaf. Food making process occurs in the blade. Leaf blade has the mid vein or midrib and many side veins. Veins carry food and water in leaf. They also support the blade, much as the metal ribs support the fabric of umbrella. Parts of leaf. Stomata on leaf. The outer surface of the leaf has many tiny pores. These openings are called stomata. These stomata enable carbon dioxide to enter the leaf. A leaf has many stomata. However, the pores are so small that they make less than 1% of the leaf's surface. Functions of leaf. A leaf performs the following functions. 1. Photosynthesis. The primary function of the leaves is to manufacture food by the process of photosynthesis. The leaves contain a green pigment called chlorophyll. 2. Interchange of gases. Leaves have numerous tiny openings called stomata. Through these minute pores, exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide occurs during photosynthesis and respiration. 3. Evaporation of water. The excess water present in the plant evaporates through stomata on the leaves. This process is called transpiration. 4. Storage of food. In onion, the fleshy leaves or scales of onion store water and food in them. Fleshy and succulent leaves of desert plants also store some water and food in them. 5. Vegetative propagation. Leaves of some plants produce buds on them. These buds can grow into new plants. How does leaf make food? Leaves make food by the process of photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is the act of making food from water, carbon dioxide, energy from the sun, and the nutrients from the soil. Plants are the only organisms in the natural world that make their own food. Chlorophyll makes this energy transformation possible. Leaves also make the energy in the air that we breathe. Chlorophyll is a pigment found in the cells of leaves, which is formed only in the presence of light and is the substance that colors plants green. Chlorophyll is contained in chloroplast and has the property of capturing light energy. Sunlight, water, carbon dioxide, oxygen. The light energy is trapped by the chlorophyll. In the leaves, a process that uses water changes the light energy into a kind of a chemical energy. This chemical energy is stored in the leaves. The leaves use the chemical energy to make food. Air enters the leaf through the stomata and moves into tiny spaces around the food-making cells in the leaf. Carbon dioxide from the air passes through the cell walls and membranes of the cells. Carbon dioxide enters the chloroplast, where the previously stored chemical energy converts the carbon dioxide into sugar. Tubes in the plant carry sugar from the leaf cells to the other parts of the plant, such as roots, stems, and fruits. Cells in these parts of the tree store some of the sugar. Roots of plants. Taproots are large and fleshy in appearance. They grow deep into the ground to search for food. They are able to store food, which is particularly necessary for perennial plants during periods of dormancy. They are mostly found in plants with two seed leaves, dicot, fibrous roots, lie close to the surface of the soil. They collect precipitation before it sinks deep into the ground. They can often be found growing side by side with tap roots. The two types of root combine efforts to maximize efficiency. Adventitious roots are mostly found in plants with one seed leaf, monocot. They develop to help the plant climb. They help to develop modified underground stems such as bulbs. They are common in both dicots and monocots. The major functions of roots are 1. Anchorage in soil. 2. Storage of energy resources such as the carrot and sugar beet. 3. Absorption of water and minerals from the soil. 4. Conduction of water and minerals to and from the shoot. The roots store the food energy resources of the plant. The food is either used by the roots themselves or digested, and the products of digestion are transported back up through the phloem to the above ground portions of the plant.